Focus is more important than intelligence. Good morning, dear children. So today we'll read about software maintenance. Hardware maintenance already completed in the previous video. Software maintenance. So software maintenance, first of all, we have to remove our virus. So about virus we have discussed. So how can you come to know that your computer has affected by a virus? What are the symptoms you will find? It reduces the speed of a computer by decreasing the memory. It causes strange movements or pattern on the screen. It displays unusual messages like your PC is stoned, etc. It increases the use of disk space and growth in file size as the virus attaches itself to many files. It leads to frequent hanging of the system. It shows abnormal write protect error, means you cannot save anything to your hard disk. That is your write protect error. Okay, it gives you, when you will save your file, it will give you error message. It displays a change in data against the file name in the directory when a virus modifies a file. Just like your picture file .jpg file may be converted to a WAV file, or WAV file may be converted to a text file like this. It reformats the hard disk. It deletes or damages the files. If any of the symptoms will come, you will means come to know that your computer is affected by a virus. Okay. Next, how can you protect our computer against virus? Virus attack not only lead to data confidentiality lost, but they also affect the way in which your computer system functions. Modified files and processes, frequent functionality disruption, modified speed, etc. are some other harmful effects of malware attack. Okay. Malware means combination of virus, worm, trojanhorse, everything. Okay. We call it as malware. So what we can install some security programs in our computer. By installing reliable antivirus is a must. Okay. The antivirus should be regularly updated. Because if we will not regularly update the antivirus, when new virus will enter into our computer, the antivirus may not be able to detect that virus. So we should regularly update our antivirus. It should also be programmed to regularly scan and quarantine the system. Okay. What other things we can do? Installation of firewalls. Firewall can be used as both, means as a software or as a hardware also. If you will use as a hardware, then you have to plug it to the CPU. And if you will use firewall as a software, then you have to install the firewall software in your computer. It works as a layer between the user and the means your computer. Okay. Restricting access to unwanted sites through appropriate settings in the browser should also be done as a mandatory act. Okay. Secure internet access. Be resilient when accessing or uploading information on the internet. Only secure sites should be used for financial transactions and no personal information should be shared or saved on any website. Means, while how can you come to know that it is a safe site or it is not a safe site? If there is a means in the address bar you will find beginning HTTPS, then it is a secure site. Hypertext Transfer Protocol Secure. Or you will find a padlock symbol in the address bar, then that is a secure site. You can see. But if only HTTP is there, it is not a secure site. So no financial transaction you should do on that site. Okay. And another thing, sometimes cookies come. Cookies means it will, while surfing the internet or any transaction you are doing, it will, there is window will appear automatically to, which will ask you to remember your password or save your password. So those cookies you should avoid. You should not save any type of confidential information in any website. Okay. Installation and download from unauthorized sources should be avoided. Okay. Regular security updates. Keep your application and operating system updated at all times. Avoid spams. Mails from unwanted and unwarranted sources should be deleted without reading or downloading. That is known as spam mails. Any attachments in such mails should never be downloaded or installed onto the system. Then backups. Backup always you take to safer data, or data can be, if it will be lost, then it can be recovered. For that backup is used. Okay. Taking backups regularly is a good practice. This is not only protect us against data loss, but also helps to restore the integrity of the data. Okay. Make sure that the data is encrypted by using encryption software to protect it from unauthorized access. What is data encryption? When the original data is converted to some other file so that it cannot be easily hacked. Okay. Just like while we are using, means typing password, that password is converted to star, hash or dot symbols. So that is one type of encryption. So, okay. So if that type of encryption software will be used to protect the data, then it will be protect from unauthorized access. What other things we can do? Scanning all portable devices. Scan all portable storage devices such as pen drive, etc. before use, as these are the most common sources of infection in the computer. Okay, that you know, before using pen drive or any other device, you should scan it. Disable cookies. As I told, cookies means that programs or windows which appear automatically while surfing the internet, which will ask you to save your password and other confidential information. So, you should not save it. Okay. So, if you take care of these things, our data can be protected and your software also will not be corrupted. Okay. So, antivirus software will use. Antivirus software are computer programs that are designed to identify, prevent and remove virus from computer. They perform the following task in computer. Scan the computer files to look for known viruses, matching definitions from the virus dictionary. Okay. Identify suspicious behavior from any computer program that might indicate infection. Simply installing an antivirus software in your computer does not guarantee 100% protection, as the installed antivirus program would not be able to detect new virus programs. Okay. So, may not be. You should keep on updating your computer with the latest version of the antivirus programs. So nowadays website also, antivirus programs are giving their website to update also. You should update it regularly. Most of the antivirus software companies provide the facility to download the latest updates from their website. Some of the popular antivirus program, Norton, McAfee, ABC, QuickHill and Avira. More are there. Okay. So now I will show you this in your book. It is given QuickHill about QuickHill antivirus software. So how can we use that QuickHill antivirus software, and what are the features available? Okay. And before that, besides this antivirus software also, we can use another maintenance schedule using this defragmentation and optimization program. Okay. When you save a file on your computer, it may not be saved in a contiguous location in the actual memory space. This leads to creating empty fragments on the disk. These fragments cause the computer system to slow down when you want to open the file again. To avoid this, you should run this defragmentor utility program on a regular basis. Okay. So next, how can we remove temporary files also. Sometimes your computer may be very slow and you might be getting disk errors. It can happen due to the temporary internet files that need to be deleted from your computer regularly. Okay. Then another, removing spam from an email account. Spam refers to the unwanted emails that you get from unknown senders. These emails are sent for the purpose of advertising, spreading malware, phishing, and often have an appropriate content. If you open a spam mail, there is a chance that a virus may attack your system or personal details may be at risk. To protect the user, almost all the email clients provide the filter feature to prevent spam messages from being delivered to your inbox. Okay. So by using filter, we can do it. Okay. Now let us see features, this defragmenter, and how to remove temporary files, and how to create a filter for the emails. Okay. So for this, QuickHill. Okay. How can you open QuickHill? If it already installed, then QuickHill Total Security. This is your QuickHill. you can see, you can scan options here, scan now. Okay, so that if you'll run this quick help program, so scan now, then it will detect for your virus. Okay, and what are the features here? You can see, if you'll go for protection, it will show you so many protections you can go for. Ransomware protection, virus protection, scan settings, safe banking, firewall, so many options are USB drive protection. You can use all this facility means to protect your data. Okay, privacy if you'll go, then data backup. Okay, webcam protection also you can do. Another one is your that is parental control, which websites you don't want to visit, you can lock it. Okay, so these all features you can select and can take the say what is benefit of it. Okay, you can performance also you can go and select. Okay, so I don't want to means I cannot show you also because it will take time. So you can try it by installing quick his antivirus in your computer and take all this facility. Okay, but if antivirus is not there also, how can you protect our computer? By using this defragmenter. Okay, defragmenter means that when big files are there, that may not get space to store in one location. Okay, if this defragmenter program you will run, then at that time operating system will collect all the small files and keep it at one place so that it can create a large space for big files. Okay, how can you do it? Simple, it is free Windows free program. You write here disk defragmenter. So this defragment and optimize drive you open. Here you can see this type of window will come. You click on analyze. Okay, you can suppose now it is not fragmented, 1% fragmented, and if you want to do, then you can do. And how to do? Then change settings you go. It will ask for you in how many days, means what way you want to defragmentation, in daily basis, in weekly basis, or in monthly basis. Choose any one. Okay, and then click on this. Drives you choose, which drive you want to defragment, C drive, D drive, E drive, system reserved, or all that is depends upon you. So you select a drive and then you click on this OK button. Okay, so that this defragmenter program will run automatically and it will prepare the hard disk. Okay, so another one is your how to delete temporary files. Okay, two ways are there to delete temporary files. You go to this PC, okay, and you select the drive. Suppose C drive, I want to, from C drive I want to delete temporary files. So right click on C drive and go to properties. Okay, here disk cleanup is there. You can click on this disk cleanup option and it will be cleared. Disk cleanup, when you click, then another window will come. Then this window you can select, it will show you that this much temporary files created in your computer and what type of temporary files are there. Downloaded program files, temporary internet files, so which type of file, recyclable files, okay, which type of file you want to delete now, files not, it is temporary files, okay, and you can select and then you can click on OK button, okay, so that it will be deleted. And if you cannot do this one, you just type here your percentile 10%. Okay, so this type of file will open for you. And see, these are the all temporary files created automatically and which has no use. And if you want to delete all the files, then press Ctrl plus A key from the keyboard. All the files will be selected. Then you right click and select the option delete. So all the temporary files will be deleted from your hard disk. And once temporary files will be deleted, then storage space will be saved. And once storage space will be there saved, computer performance will increase. Okay, that is one of the way. Now how to create filter for our mails. For Gmail it is free, so let us see the Gmail. Open your account. Okay, suppose I have opened my account. You go to your inbox. okay, your inbox will be opened. So for any mail, how can you set a filter? Okay, suppose here you go, search mail bar, okay, where it is written, then this triangle symbol, click here. Then it is asking for which mail you want to create a filter. Suppose in my inbox, many mails are from this site and I want to stop it. Okay, so after writing create a filter, click. This will come. Not only delete, you can suppose important mails also you can do also. Sorry. This box, okay. So you can skip the inbox, mark as read, star it, you can delete it also. And if it is coming from authorized source, you can make it always mark it as important also. You can create a filter, clear? So if these all options you can use to create a filter, okay. So if you will create a suppose every on means unauthorized emails you want to delete, so click on the delete option, okay. And after that you will find means a filter will be created, okay. So this way you can create a filter for your mails which are coming from unauthorized sources. Now comes to how can you delete spam mails, okay. In the right side you go, here more button will be there, click on this more button, okay. And here you will find spam, click on spam. There is no spam mail, but if spam mails will be there, it will show in this box, okay. And you select all the spam mails, right click and delete it, okay. So all the spam mails will be deleted. No need to open the spam mail because it may contain virus. And if you will set a filter for a particular mail that which are coming from unauthorized sources, that will be means block, you can delete, you can mark as read, star, whatever you want to do with that mail, you can use that filter option to do, so that your data can be protected, no virus will be entered into our computer and our computer will be safe and we can use it efficiently and for a long time, okay. So for today this much, and the lesson completed. Question answer I'll send you in the next class. Thank you all, have a nice day.